Sukhendu Sekhar Roy.
Thank you, sir. While speaking on the Constitution, 99th Constitution Amendment Bill 2014, I like to make clear that my party, the All India Trinamool Congress, and our leader, Ms. Mamata Banerjee, always we believe in the independence of judiciary and the powers of judicial review. We neither believe in committed judiciary, as was propagated in the 70s, and I have a right to speak. When your turn will come, you will. I repent. No. When your turn will come, you will speak.
आप बोलने दीजिए.
Being a senior member, you know the rules of this house. Okay. I have every right to say. So we have seen in this country how the judiciary was made to measure in the mid-70s, and what was the resultant effect on our body polity. Therefore, we are very much cautious. It is true that we have learned by lessons. It is true that our judiciary, particularly the High Court and the Supreme Court, in plethora of cases, have given landmark judgments ensuring a justice, social, political, and economic as enshrined in the preamble to the Constitution of India. No doubt about it. But when we look at the process of selection of judges, we feel disturbed. Because as rightly pointed out by Santaramji a few minutes back, that in no democratic country of the world such a collegium system exists. He has mentioned a number of names of number of countries. I am giving one example of one country, Switzerland. In Switzerland, the Swiss Federal Assembly, the members of the Swiss Federal Assembly, they appoint the members of Swiss Federal Court. But through this amendment bill or the other bill, we are not seeking that power of Switzerland, that the members of parliament will appoint the judges of the Supreme Court. Rather, we are trying to evolve a system. Why? Our Honorable Law Minister, while introducing the bill, he has given a chronological account as to how we have dealt with this thing. We are thinking of this for the past 24 years without arriving at any conclusion whatsoever. How long we should wait, and why it is required, why it is necessary? Because everybody knows that what is the effect of the second judge's case judgment. And Supreme Court itself changed the basic structure of the Constitution by interpreting a particular article, by importing a new interpretation. Although we know that in several cases Supreme Court has said that while interpreting a particular word, no other than the ordinary dictionary meaning, no other interpretation should be imported. But in that case, Supreme Court interpreted in a manner which is prejudicial to the interest of functioning of the judiciary in this country. This is why I support and I think that this bill is very much necessary. Sir, this balance has been upset by the second judge's case, and the original balance of power needs to be restored. We need to restore the status quo ante. Otherwise, the very purpose of the constitutional goal will be frustrated. The constitution makers, what they thought what they perceived and what they made while enacting the constitution, that will also be frustrated and it will be a disrespect to the framers of the constitution, according to us. Sir, even the National Commission to Review the Working of the Indian Constitution, it said, and I quote, it would be worthwhile to have a participatory mode with the participation of both the executive and the judiciary in making such recommendations. The Commission proposes the composition of the collegium which gives due importance to and provides for the effective participation of both the executive and the judicial wings of the state as an integrated scheme for the machinery for appointment of judges. The Commission accordingly recommends the establishment of a National Judicial Commission under the Constitution. So this recommendation was of 2002. We are in 2014, still discussing. I will finish. I will conclude now with a remark of the very honorable judge who was one of the architect of the judgment of second judge's case, late Justice Verma. What he said, kindly allow me 2-3 lines only, because that is very vital. Even he appeared before our standing committee. We had the opportunity to hear him. In other areas, he said the same thing, and I am quoting from him. He is saying, late Justice J.S. Verma, who was one of the authors of second judge's case, on a later reflection, observed that, quote, my 1993 judgment has been both misunderstood and misused. Therefore, some kind of rethink is required on my judgment, and that the appointment process of High Court and Supreme Court judges is basically a joint or participatory participatory process between the executive and the judiciary, both taking part in it. And what, unquote, and what happened in this constitutional amendment bill or the other bill? When we'll discuss on that also. Yeah, not only the executive and judiciary have been empowered, but even civil society has been included. Two eminent persons of the civil society have been included in the process of selection. What is the objection? Where lies the objection? I personally feel, strongly feel, that the government has tried to widen the scope of selection by way of introducing this constitutional amendment bill, and I support this bill on behalf of my party.
Thank you.